In this video, I teach you the basic parts of a boiler. And these parts are important terms of a boiler because these parts are used in every type of boiler. So generally that is a 10 to 11 parts that is used in every type of the boiler. The first part is the cylindrical cell. So it is a cell in which different parts of boilers are enclosed. Means all the parts of the boiler are inside the cell and on which the different mountings are fitted. Means different mountings are fitted on a boiler cell. So boiler cell are made from a flat plate of a metal. So this is a generally cast iron plate is used. Okay. And this type of the cell is looking. So this is a cylindrical cell. Inside that is a furnace is there. And the another fire tubes, water tubes are there. Okay, depending on the types of the boiler. So this cell is made from a flat plate. So first up the plate is flat like the page of a book. Then after this sheet metal is wound by using this roller machine. Means this type of the machine is used to make the cylindrical cell of a boiler. Okay, so this is the main parts. Inside that all the components are installed. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and press the subscribe button to watch the more video. Second part is the grate. So grate is a one part of the furnace and it is the platform in a furnace on which the fuel is burnt. So grate is a one part of the furnace on which various fuel are putting for a combustion purpose. So grate is look like this. Okay. So here I show you this image. So this is the complete furnace. And this is the door of the furnace. From this door, the different fuel is supplied inside the furnace grate. Okay. So this is the bottom part. It is known as the grate. In a grate, that is a various space is provided. Here I show you that. Okay. So after this combustion, the air particle is going down from this part. And fresh air is also come from this bottom part of this grate. Okay. So from this below part, the air is supplied to the fuel for a proper combustion. And the final part remains, that is known as the S. So it is also supplied below from this hall. So this is the grate and the next is the furnace. Furnace is also known as the firebox. So what is a furnace? It is a chamber formed by a space above the boiler cell. Means it is a upper part, it is a made in a bottom part of the boiler cell in which combustion takes place. Means inside the furnace the combustion of the fuel is takes place, and for the proper combustion we are required the fuel as well as the air, means oxygen, and a one spark to start the combustion. And this is also known as the firebox because inside there is a fire. Okay, that's why it is also known as the firebox. This chamber contains the hot gases produced by combustion of the fuel. So inside the furnace the hot gases are produced, then after it is supplied to the fire tubes as well as to the water tubes on depend on the which type of the boiler is there. Next part is the fire hall. So it is a hall through which all or a various fuel is added to the furnace. Means the place from which the different fuel is supplied to the furnace, it is known as the fire hall. So in this image you see this. This is the door as well as the fire hall. In some book they are tell the fire hall, in some book they are talk as the fire door. So fire hall and fire door both are the same components. So from this door or a hall, the combustion, coal or the different fuel is supplied to the furnace. It is known as the fire hall. Next is the S pit or a S pan. So it is the area in which S of a burnt coil is collected. So after the burning of a coil, the last particle remains, it is known as the S. Okay. And this is the S is the final product of the coal after the combustion. So coal S pit is generally installed below this grate. Okay. Because from this hall, the S is going downside and there is a collected in a S pan as well as the S pit. Now the next component is a smoke chamber. So whatever the hot gas is produced in a furnace is supplied to the fire tube. Okay. Then after the outlet of the fire tubes, that is the one box is provided, and that is known as the smoke chamber or a smoke box. So waste gases are collected here and they are released to the chimney and then to atmosphere. So smoke box and the smoke chambers are generally installed after the fire tubes. Okay, so in that the various gases is collected, then after it is supplied to chimney, and through the chimney it is go to the atmosphere. Next is the man hall. It is a hall provided for the man. Okay, from this hall men are able to go inside the boiler when the boiler is under the maintenance or for inspection purpose. Okay, during the working condition this hall is closed. Okay, so it is a hall provided on the boiler cell so that workmen can go inside the boiler for inspection, cleaning and maintenance purpose during the boiler is switch off. Okay. Another is the hand hall. It is a hall provided on a cell to give easy access for the purpose of cleaning the water tubes or some other internal parts of a boiler, and they are also fitted with covers. So this is a small halls provided for a cleaning purpose of a water tubes. Okay. So we are not required to go inside from a main hall to cleaning purpose. So we can easily clean by using this hand hall. Next part is a mud box. So mud box, it collect the all impurity present in the water. Okay. And it is at the bottom of barrel or cell, and these impurities are removed time to time by the help of blower pump. Means at the end of the tank, that is a different impurity is collected. So we observe in a water tank, some impurities are settled down in the tank. The same way in a fire tube boilers, water is outside the tube. At that time what happened, the impurities of the water is settled down in a furnace cell, sorry, in a boiler cell. Okay, so these impurities are removed by using this mud box. And the next part is the steam collecting pipe, or it is also known as the anti-priming pipe. So steam is generally collected in a upper part of a cell. Okay, so when steam leaving the boiler, it contains a certain amount of the water, so this is known as the wet steam. So anti-priming pipe is used to separate the water particles from a steam. So anti-priming pipe is used to remove the water particles from a steam, and it is collected the dry steam from the boiler. So anti-priming pipe only collect the steam, that is a dry steam, and then it is supplied to the whenever it is to be the required. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.